Angela, thank you. Nearly 2 hours of intense negotiations took place before the standoff ended in gunfire. News 4's Myra Ruiz joins us live and local with more on this story tonight. Myra.
Well, Gabby, the lead negotiator can't talk about the specifics of this case, but says in general they don't let family members talk because it's possible that it could just upset the suspect. But he did give us a better idea of what they do to keep these situations from escalating.
By 3 p.m. Tuesday, the negotiation process was already underway. With a SWAT team in place, negotiators could try to get Zach Whitfield talking. In cases like this, the path to resolution begins with a calm conversation.
Sooner or later, they're going to come down to your level when you can start talking with them. And when you do that, you just start calming them down and hearing their side of the story.
Many times, the suspect is upset and just wants someone to hear why.
We actually give them a phone. It's a special phone. It's in a little box.
A special phone delivered with help from an armored truck and the SWAT team. But getting it there is slow and deliberate because they never know how the suspect will react.
It is stressful, but you just have to have that goal that you know what you want and try to put that off for a little while till you get done.
But the goal is to keep the suspect from doing anything to harm himself or anyone else.
You try to key in on the positive stuff and get away from the negatives.
It can take minutes or hours to build a rapport and convince the suspect to surrender, but that's not what happened on Tuesday evening.
Anytime we have a situation that doesn't end like we'd like it resolved peacefully, you know, it affects each of us, especially the ones that are on the phone and have been talking with this person, whether it's just a little while or for hours.
There's also a secondary negotiator who doesn't actually speak to the suspect but gathers background on him or her while everything is going on. Nigel?